are safe at your home, right? Today we will discuss about the cell organelles actually. Like human being, like human body, like for example, we have a various system for the various life processes. For example, digestive system for digestion, right? Respiratory system for exchange of gases, circulatory system for transport of materials, and all these so on, right? Similarly, cell also have their own organelle which perform various function for cell, right? Various life processes for the cell. So cell organelles are generally present in the cytoplasm of the cell, and they perform various function according to the requirement of the cell, right? Each cell have capability of division also, and each cell have a specific lifespan. For example, different cell have different kind of lifespan, simply you can say that. For example, neuron cell does not divide after the birth, simply you can say that, because they do not have capability of division. But any other cells which are present in our body, the somatic cells, which have actually capacity for division, and for this division and for the various metabolic activities and growth of the cell actually performed by the cell organelles, right? So today we will discuss the various cell organelles, how they are formed, what their function, and where they are present actually, right? Cell organelles are of actually two types, this membrane bounded organelles and non-membrane organelles. Actually, the membrane bounded organelles are present in eukaryotic case, right? In eukaryotics, all the organelles are membrane bounded, but in case of prokaryotic, the membrane bounded organelles are absent. Only the non-membrane bounded organelle is present. So there is only one organelle which has membrane absent, simply the ribosome. Actually, ribosome does not have membrane, right? First we discuss about the the endoplasmic reticulum. It is a membrane bounded organelle similar to the plasma membrane. It is actually formed by the modification of the plasma membrane, by the folding of the plasma membrane, you can say that, right? It is actually the network of plasma membrane bounded and form a structure is called the endoplasmic reticulum. Simply, it is form a membrane, network of membrane, by making the tubules and vesicles. Two different type of structure is present. Tubules is like that, and vesicles is spherical structure, right? So these two different type of structures are present in endoplasmic reticulum. These are generally present near the membrane, either it is a plasma membrane or either it is a nuclear membrane, because they are the origin of membrane. So they are actually present near the plasma membrane of cell or nucleus, nuclear membrane and plasma membrane, right? These are mainly of two types, rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The rough endoplasmic reticulum appear rough under the microscope. Why they appear rough? Because they consist ribosome on their surface, right? And because of the ribosome actually the protein factory, ribosome have capability for the synthesis of protein. So these are because they consist ribosome, they have capability for the formation of protein. It means they synthesize the protein in the cell. They have capability for the synthesis of protein. Next is the SER, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum actually appears smooth under the microscope because lipid or fat molecules are present in their membrane. So these actually help for the formation of fat molecules and lipid molecules. And each the plasma membrane actually made up of the protein and the fat or a lipid molecule. So both these organelles of endoplasmic reticulum help in the membrane formation. So because they help in membrane formation, so this process is called membrane biogenesis. Actually, they help in the formation of membrane, so it is called membrane biogenesis. This process is actually called the membrane biogenesis, simply, right? One important thing about the endoplasmic reticulum is that it help in the transportation of material also. Actually, the protein and lipid both are the very important materials in our body and in the cell for the building block, for the development and for the growth of any cell or any part of your body. So they help for the transport of protein from the rough endoplasmic reticulum and lipid from the smooth endoplasmic reticulum to the required, to the target organ, to the target site where the requirement of these material is occur simply, right? So they are endoplasmic reticulum is very important. One more important thing about the SER, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, is that in our liver, liver have capability to absorb the toxic substances present in your food, in your blood, and in the connective part of your blood, simply lymph, blood, whatever, right? So it may cause, due to the increase in the toxicity, may cause the infection in the liver. So smooth endoplasmic reticulum play very important role in that case. It detoxify these toxic substances from the liver and make the liver free from these toxic substances. So smooth endoplasmic play very important role in that case. One more important thing is rough endoplasmic reticulum is present near the membrane, near the nuclear membrane, because it help in the formation of protein, and these protein transferred from the nuclear pore into the nucleus. So it is present near the nuclear membrane, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum present nearby the rough endoplasmic reticulum. So they are actually present nearby the membrane, plasma membrane simply you can say that. Next is the Golgi apparatus. This is also a very important organelle, because the material which are formed by the endoplasmic reticulum are transported or packed by the Golgi apparatus, and after the packaging they are transported to the target site or target organ of your body. So the Golgi apparatus, the name of Golgi was given on the basis of the name of the scientist Camillo Golgi, because he gave the first concept about the Golgi apparatus. So it is a membrane bound vesicles arranged parallel to each other. They are present like this. This is the arrangement of Golgi apparatus. Like this. Right? This is the arrangement of Golgi apparatus. These are the parallel sticks, which is called cisternae, and the small vesicles are present over both the surfaces on the cis face and trans face. The upper face is called the cis face and the lower face is called the trans face actually. These vesicles, what the function of these vesicles? These vesicles actually store the materials which are formed by the RER and SER. They store these materials, protein and lipid, and transport these parallel sticks, which is called cisternae, and transport to the trans vesicles, trans phase vesicles, and through these, from the here, these vesicles are transported to the target site of your body or your body organs. Right, so this is also a membrane bound organelle. It means it is present into the eukaryotic organism. One more important thing about the Golgi apparatus is that the sperm, which is present in the male, the head portion consists, and acrosome part is made up of actually the Golgi apparatus. This acrosome part consists the hydrolytic enzyme, which is actually used for the dissociation of an egg membrane. So which this also formed by the Golgi apparatus. One more important thing about the Golgi apparatus is that it also help in the formation of lysosome. So lysosome is also formed with the help of Golgi apparatus. It is a very important question for 1 marks, right? Next is the lysosome. Lysosome is also very important for your cell, because it is act as a waste disposal. The waste parts, waste particle in your cell, not body, present in your cell is removed out with the help of actually lysosome, because it has a very special enzyme, is called digestive enzyme. This digestive enzyme actually formed with the help of RER, rough endoplasmic reticulum. So due to this digestive enzyme, all the waste material of your cell is digested from the complex organic material to the simple inorganic material, which is again used by your cell only. right? So it is actually the waste disposal system, and keep yourself clean and hygienic, simply you can say that, because due to the waste particles, waste substances, maybe your cell become infected. Sometime if your cell get infected or maybe injured, right, in that condition what will happen, in that condition the lysosome, the cell become burst, the lysosome burst up and release their digestive enzyme, and these digestive enzyme actually digest their own cell actually. So that's why this organelle is also called the suicidal bag, you can say that, because it have capability to digest its own cell under condition only. It does not digest their own cell anytime during the any infection, during any injury in your cell, or any infection which occur in the neighboring cell, and the cell have maybe chances for the infection, in that condition only the lysosome burst up and release their digestive enzyme, and these digestive enzyme actually digest the own cell to reduce the chances of the infection to the neighboring cell, simply the neighboring cell which is present around the infected cell, to reduce this infection. Actually the lysosome burst up, release their digestive enzyme and digest their own cells. Next is your very important organelle is the mitochondria. This is also called the powerhouse of the cell, because this is the organelle which have capability to synthesize the energy currency, which is called the ATP. ATP, adenosine triphosphate, actually this is the energy currency of your body. The energy which is used for the metabolic activities, for the various catabolism and anabolism reaction, which occur only in the presence of ATP only. In our body, after the digestion of the food, glucose is also oxidized in the form of ATP energy. This energy is actually used for the metabolic activities and biochemical reactions in your body. Similarly, cell also have that kind of organelle which have capability for formation of this ATP actually. So this is this organelle is called the powerhouse of the cell. Mitochondria has special quality. It is a double membrane organelle. Two membranes, outer and inner membrane, are present in the mitochondria, and the inner membrane become fold up like this. This is your structure of your mitochondria. This is the inner membrane, and this become fold up into a zigzag manner, and this zigzag manner consists a very small bulb like structure. These bulb like structure actually called the oxysome. And these oxysomes actually have capability for the formation of ATP. They have an enzyme is called ATPase. Due to this enzyme, this ATP is formed in the mitochondria, and this zigzag structure is called cristae, right? Mitochondria also have their own DNA. It is the special quality about the mitochondria, and one more organelle is there, is called plastid or chloroplast. Chloroplast also have their own DNA. It means they have capability to and ribosome also, they have capability to synthesize their own protein, and it has capability to restore their genetic information into in only in mitochondria. So because it has their genetic material as well as the ribosome for the protein synthesis, double membrane, and the very important is the powerhouse of the cell, and which help for the formation of energy currency is called ATP. This is all about these four organelles. Remaining organelles we will do in our next lecture. Thank you.